Having your own place is a dream come true for me and for almost everyone I know from the industry. I can tell you it's the most challenging thing I have done in my life, besides being a parent. And yeah, until I became a parent, this was the most challenging thing. And then, but it's also the most satisfying thing I've done. So it's yeah. I think for there are a lot of people coming to us, coming to me, asking, okay, we want to open here, we want to do that, we want to do that. Usually, I say, I try to scare them a bit. Not because it's frightening, just because you need to know what you're going into. So it's an amazing experience, but it's also extremely difficult. There will be a lot of obstacles along the way. And who asked me before? You did. What does an entrepreneur needs? So it needs to push forward all the time, all the time, all the time. And you need to know everything. You need to know how to do marketing, how to run employees. You need to know how to fix the air conditioning that breaks. You need to know how to fix the toilet. You need to know, or you need to find the people that know this. But eventually, if they don't succeed, it's still up to you to find the solution. You need to want it to work, and don't take no for an answer. Whatever you're dealing with, whether it's legislation, or standards, or permits, or whatever, or if you need money, or if you need everything, no is not an answer. And you have to find the solution. So it's a, and also once the hostel, until you make it happen, until you open the place, it's an amazing ride. But from the moment it was open, it's only the beginning, and then it's a 24/7 job. Because there are some people sleeping in your place, and you are in charge of them. They are not babies. They can take care of themselves, but if something happens to them, or not to think of the bad stuff, you want it to be the best experience they ever had. So it's always on your mind. Whether if you are there or not, and you will be there a lot of your time, it's a 24/7 job. And okay, maybe you slowly find some people to help you, this place must grow, okay, but still, if it's your place, it's yours, your problems, your benefits, it's all together. So, the two other things, one of them Efrat already mentioned, for new entrepreneurs that are asking me, I say, go and gain some experience, like Efrat mentioned, whether it's working hostel, but also if you work in a hotel, if you work in a B&B, just have some experience with working, with hosting people. Once you do that, even if you work in a hotel, even if you work in something which is completely different than a regular hostel, but still, it's tourism, it's hosting, it's accommodation industry, that's wonderful. That's a very, very meaningful experience. Very. I started in the camp lodge. I was cleaning tents, I was cleaning toilets, I was then getting the guests, starting to work in the reservations, did some marketing, did everything. We were only me and Gilly doing everything there. It's a two-man show. You learn a lot. You learn a lot from doing stuff like that. But also if it's a big place and you are working reception or housekeeping or kitchen or whatever. And the second thing is go and see for yourself, better to stay, but also see for yourself as many places as possible. So you are here now, you saw yesterday the Jerusalem Hostel and Abraham Hostel. These are only two examples. Oh, and we have some ideas, some vision, some thoughts about what's true and what's wrong. But there are 33 hostels in ILH, and there are also other hostels outside of ILH. And go, see them, check them out. See what others are doing. Follow what people are doing in Europe or in other parts of the world. And go visit in Amman, go visit in Ramallah, Mike's place, go visit in wherever. It's very, very important. So take the time to go and see and learn. It's a very important lesson that you can learn along the way. A lot of the people that you meet might tell you, Arnon, that you met yesterday from Jerusalem Hostel, he's the owner of Jerusalem Hostel and Old Jaffa Hostel. He's in the business for over 30 years now. When Maoz started the Fauzi, he came before to Arnon, asked him, Arnon, I want to open a hostel in the old city of Nazareth. And he told him, you're crazy, don't do it. You will lose your pants. No, no, don't do it, it's crazy. He did it, and then Arnon told him, I was wrong and I'm glad I was wrong. Before we started ILH, we went to sit down with Arnon. He said, Arnon, what do you think? We want to form a union of hostels to work together, to set a standard, to do a map, to do this. He said, listen, it's a crazy idea. I don't think it would work, but if you do it, I will join you. And he was the first to join. And he's now on the board of ILH, and he's cooperating, and he's happy about that. And it's we are happy that he's part of this great thing. And he was happy to be wrong again. So I would be happy to be very wrong about everything I say. If someone tells you, you want to open a hostel in Petah Tikva, Miki. And I would say it's nuts, no chance. I would be glad to be wrong, okay?